Over in the U.S., the suspect in the shooting massacre in Georgia last month pleads not guilty to four more counts of murder and other charges. 22-year-old Robert Aaron Long is accused of killing a total of 8 people, most of them of Asian descent, at 3 spas in or near Atlanta. He pleaded guilty in July to 4 of the slayings. Okay. The March attacks galvanized awareness of the wave of anti-Asian bias and violence across the U.S. during the coronavirus pandemic, which former President Donald Trump repeatedly blamed on China. The prosecutor in the case has announced she would seek the death penalty and enhanced sentencing for hate crimes against Long based on the race and gender of the victims. The chief of the World Health Organization vows to punish WHO employees involved in sexual abuse incidents during an Ebola crisis in Congo. Here's the full story.
The World Health Organization is heartbroken, its regional director for Africa has said, after an independent commission found that 21 out of 83 alleged perpetrators of sex abuse in Democratic Republic of Congo were employed by the WHO. Dr. Matsidiso Moeti was speaking at a media briefing on Tuesday.
We in WHO are indeed humbled, horrified, and heartbroken by the findings of this inquiry. I'd like also to thank all the women and girls who have come forward and given evidence to the investigation, and thus have given us the basis on which to take action in WHO, which has been necessary.
The commission found that the abuse, including 9 allegations of rape, were committed by both national and international staff. The report said alleged victims were also not provided with the necessary support and assistance required for such degrading experiences. In an investigation published last year by the Thomson Reuters Foundation and The New Humanitarian, more than 50 women accused aid workers from the WHO and leading charities of demanding sex in exchange for jobs during the 2018 to 2020 Ebola crisis. WHO Director General Tedros Adhanom Ghebreyesus said the commission's report made for harrowing reading.
I'm sorry for what was done to you by people who were employed by WHO to serve and protect you. I'm sorry for the ongoing suffering that these events must cause. I'm sorry that you have had to relieve them in talking to the Commission about your experiences.
Tedros said the organization will ban those identified as perpetrators from future employment with the WHO and would notify the broader UN system. He said the WHO was terminating the contracts of 4 people identified as perpetrators who were still employed by the agency when it was made aware of the allegations against them.